this season on Fight Girls.
Is your neck up? Good.
You can't share with me.
Please, don't you have something else to focus on?
Don't talk to me.
These 10 girls will move into this Las Vegas mansion.
This room is huge.
They will live together, laugh together, cry together. We'll see who they date, who they hate.
F*** you! I will pile back there and kick your ass!
And who they hurt. Because these girls are here to learn how to battle in the deadly martial art of Muay Thai fighting. This man will teach them. He is Master Toddy, the legendary trainer who has molded more than 40 champions.
Nine, is it? Remember that.
With the help of two of his champions, he will lead these girls to use their fists, feet, elbows, and knees. Every week, one will be eliminated in the ring. The goal for these girls is to make it to the final five and go to Thailand to face their fear, fight the ultimate opponent, a Thai champion, the toughest female fighters on the planet. In the end, at stake is a world championship. But to get to Thailand, they have to get out of Vegas. And to get out of Vegas, they have to fight each other. This is Fight Girls.
This house is gorgeous.
I need to find the freezer.
Jacuzzi! My name is Janine Jackson. When I was little, I had asked my parents over and over again, can't I do karate? Like, they're like, no, no contact sports for you. But there's always been a side of me that has always just wanted to fight and like throw down. And I've had to control that all of my life.
My name is Miriam Herbie Nakamoto. I like fighting. Just being in the moment and going for it and hitting somebody and getting hit and just being a savage, you know?
Where's everyone else?
My name is Arja Hernandez. I'm 31 years old. I live in Las Vegas, Nevada.
I'm a cocktail waitress downtown, and I go home and I have a daughter. She's 10.
Oh, what's her name?
Aubrey.
Aubrey.
Yeah, she was sad, but that I left.
I have a daughter. She does Muay Thai herself. She's everything to me. And I'm doing this for her. I want her to look at me and just, I want to be the woman in her life that she wants to be.
My name is Carrie Vera. I'm from San Diego, California. I've always known that fighting was a passion of mine. My husband fights for UFC. I've wanted more for myself because I see him doing so well. And I'm like, oh, that's so cool. You know, I really want to do that too.
My name is Gina Reyes. I own a gym with my boyfriend. It's a big opportunity for me to get more women involved in the sport.
Hello. My name is Dawn Boyd. I'm from Las Vegas, Nevada. I would describe myself as competitive. I'm high maintenance sometimes, but for the most part, I'm pretty laid back.
Is this our room? Do we get a share?
We can.
No, we don't want any.
Chew, already naked. Yeah.
My name's Michelle.
Hi. My name's Michelle Watterson, and I'm from Denver, Colorado. Martial arts has always been a part of my life. I started with sport karate, but I really wanted to know if I could handle myself physically, like if I could take a punch. So I started training Muay Thai.
Did you guys get food already? What are you?
My name is Lisa Mills. I'm from New York City. I'm a teacher there, and I started training Muay Thai for the fitness.
My name is Jennifer Tate. I fight out of Stockton. I'm a single mom and a fighter.
What's up?
Hi.
I'm Janine.
I'm good. Felice.
My name is Felice Herrig, and I'm from Buffalo Grove, Illinois.
I actually grew up with a family of five kids, and we didn't have money, and I didn't have a lot of opportunities that other kids had. You know, that's why I think I'm so passionate with fighting, because I know what it feels like to want something so bad and to not have it. Now, you know, nobody's gonna stop me.
Good morning, Master Toddy. How are you?
I'm great.
Lisa got a call from Master Toddy that everybody needed to hurry up and get to Red Rock.
What time you want us there?
I'd like you to come now.
Right now?
Yeah.
All right, ladies, you hear that? And we have to go right now.
Red Rock, it's kind of a spiritual place because it's so beautiful. You can kind of connect with yourself.
Welcome to the FICO team.
All of a sudden, Master Toddy is up on this big rock. He said hi and welcomed us.
I'm looking forward to meet all of you. I'd like you each to find your own way to me.
So Master Toddy asked us to find our own path up to the rock. And to me, that immediately meant that, you know, as individuals, he's really looking to see who we are and what path we take.
I've never met Master Toddy before, and I'm really excited. That's why I ran right up the middle of the rock. I wanted to be the first girl up there to meet him.
Him telling us to find our own path was really symbolic for me. You know, it gets hard, you'll slip, you fall, but when you make it to the top, what you did wasn't for a waste.
And welcome again. You know, the reason I bring you here, because I want to learn from you. I want to learn how you move. Jennifer, you're the first one. You climb up very high up. You have a lot of determination. Felice, why are you here?
I love to fight, yeah.
I was really young when I lost my brother. He had cancer, but I've realized, you know, through my brother's death, that anything that I do have control over in my life, I'm gonna, you know, do it so that I don't have any regrets.
You think to go to Thailand to fight with Thai champion is easy?
No, sir.
You know what you have to go through?
I'm so excited to train with Master Toddy right now. I've wanted to train with him for years. This is my chance to, you know, go big or go home.
Enjoy a beautiful day here. I will see you tomorrow. Sawadee krap.
Sawadee krap.
Hey, somebody's knocking, you guys.
Hi.
Hey. Hi,
I'm Gina.
Gina.
Yeah.
I'm Gina Carano. I'm 24 years old. I've been to Thailand, I fought, and I won. Master Toddy chose me as a mentor to help these girls get ready for Thailand.
Welcome to Fight Girls.
This is a competition.
Five of you guys are going to be going to Thailand.
And five of you are going home. Every week, two girls will fight.
Whoever loses goes home.
When Gina told us that we were going to be fighting each other, I was like, great. You know, I wasn't happy about it.
The person you're sitting next to, you might be punching in the face as hard as you can. That makes it fun.
Walking around the house, you just don't really know who you want to bond with because it might be the person you're fighting.
In your mind, it's always like the biggest goal you could reach is going to Thailand and fighting, like, because Muay Thai, it's their national sport.
I'm gonna win. I'm going to Thailand. I know deep down inside I'm gonna crush it. I know I have what it takes.
So thanks everybody for being here. It's gonna be an honor for me to be a part of this with you guys. So sweet dreams.
Welcome to the Lionheart Gym. To be a Muay Thai fighter, you got to be tough. You think of all of you will have a lion heart?
Yes, sir.
I'm sorry to tell you, only five go to Thailand. You have to prove it. You have to win to be new generation of fight girl. This is very important that to have champion have been to Thailand, fought before in Thailand. So that's why I like to bring Lisa King and Gina Carano.
The sport of Muay Thai was born about 1,000 years ago in Thailand. It's the deadliest form of martial arts. You get in there, you use your hands just like a boxer, you use your elbows, you use your knees, and you use your feet. That's the basis of Muay Thai, is using the strongest portions of your body.
Ready, set, back, go. Another 5 push-up with a knuckle. That's it. And when you get up, I want you to carry that fist like a hammer.
Master Toddy is a genius when it comes to fighting Muay Thai. There's no better. He trains people to fight with his heart. He keeps you focused mentally, and he's just got unbelievable technique.
Right away. Good, 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 good. Tell her I'm not going to stop. I'm going to win. Now you're my enemy. Only 5 of you are going to go to Thailand. My philosophy of training is repeat again and again and again. Make the master of each technique. And make sure that they remember and move to the next technique. Push! 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 Time! Alright, shake hands together.
Master Toddy had us all in the ring together, and he asked us to close our eyes. He told us that he would be selecting the first fighters, you know, for the first fight.
I go to pick the first bout.
I was standing there, literally, my heart felt like it was gonna pop out of my chest. My palms were sweaty. I was just really nervous.
Now you can open your eyes.
I opened my eyes and there she is, Felice. I smiled and I immediately calmed down. This was what I wanted, Felice. It's, you know, she's just one more obstacle.
I want to win so bad. I mean, more than anything. I believe there's a fighter inside of me. I don't see a fighter inside of Gina.
Felice and Gina will be the first bout this week. When I saw the 10 girl, I know that Felice and Gina, they're very close in weight and experience, and the way they train, the way they fight, the way they move. So we need to pick right away that who should stay and who should go.
Coming up next, the girls gang up on Miriam. Then, the first fight. Two girls battle for one spot.
Felice moved into the master bedroom with Miriam, which could have been a mistake because when Miriam was first here, she kind of wanted to be away from everyone.
Have you seen Miriam this morning? I didn't see her. I saw everyone but her.
Mm-mm. I heard maybe she was sleeping in her closet.
Really? Let's go see.
I found Miriam in the closet, and I thought it was because of what happened last night.
We kind of got in a fight last night. She said, like, you know, she needs her space and she needs to be alone. And I said, well, if you want your space.
Last night, I was trying to sleep, and she was kind of like, you know, moseying around and, you know, in the room, like, flicking on the light switches and everything.
But she woke me up at, like, 4 a.m. because she said that when she invited me to stay in the room that apparently is hers, that it was a mistake. That I guess I inconvenienced her aura. But, so like we just talked about it and I was like trying to like negotiate something with her, and then I found her in there in the morning.
Should we just leave her then or should we wake her up?
Yeah.
Leave her there?
Yeah.
I'll go wake her up. We gotta go to the gym pretty soon, okay?
Oh, God, okay.
We've got like 30 minutes.
But how are we gonna eat?
Dude. All right.
It was a little stressful for me, just waking up and then having to rush. Oh, my God, we have to leave right now. I don't have any food in me, trying to make a shake.
So I didn't hear nothing, but I guess you guys were like going at it last night or what?
Well, all I said was like, you know what? I need my space. And she's like, well, blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, whoa.
Hey,
cover that face. Jeff.
I can only help these girls drawing from the experiences that I've had.
It's just so important to have that one person there that really believes in you and really knows you. And I have to get there in a matter of a couple days with these girls.
I am very happy that I have Gina because I've seen her fight, and every time I see her fight, I'm like, wow, you know, I kind of have a similar fighting style. I just keep going and going and going. They call me the little bulldog.
Yeah. Kapalise, she's just a little fighter. You know, she's had boxing fights, kickboxing fights, whatever. She really just needs to start honing in on Muay Thai because Gina has the better technique.
I was really excited when Master Toddy assigned Lisa King as my mentor.
Her confidence and her aggressiveness in the ring is something that I have inside of me, but I just haven't found how to get it out in the ring yet, and I think she can help me with that.
Gina has ridiculously strong kicks, and she has Muay Thai experience.
Good job.
I feel really confident for this fight right now. I really do.
All comes down to how bad you want it, so. Yeah. And you want it.
I do.
I really feel like I've already won.
That's a silly question.
Why is that? Do you kind of want to do it by yourself?
I kind of want to just because I think I'm going to get nervous once I see you. But I've never fought without you.
Well, maybe you should then.
My relationship with my boyfriend's crazy. He's my coach. He is my trainer. So the lines get crossed.
But then I'm thinking, I'm like, okay, I'm gonna be good. I'm confident. And then like the last minute, I'd be like, where's my boyfriend?
I've gotten things easy in my life, and I know it's because of my looks. And I think I've always wondered if I had been born with a different face and a different body, would I still be the strong person that I really believe I am? And I think getting in the ring by myself is that, you know, it's just proving to myself that, you know, deep down inside, like, yeah, you know, I am strong and I will do whatever it takes, no matter what I look like.
You're about to prove that you're a champion, and just go out there and do what you do.
Okay.
All right, man.
All right.
Okay, have a good night.
All right, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Love you, bye.
Well, if I want him there, like, I don't know.
What's your hesitation?
I don't know, maybe just because I've been feeling so confident. I don't want anything to mess with it right now. You know what I mean?
Did your parents come, and your sister?
My mom doesn't know I'm here. My family doesn't know I'm here.
What?
Yeah.
How do they not know you're here?
My dad knows I'm here. Because my mom, I told you, my mom's not very supportive of me fighting.
My mom's not either, but I at least told her.
You know, I just feel like if my mom knew, she would be excited about it, and I'd be like, well, you weren't excited before.
I told my mom, and she freaked out. And she was like, you can't do this. Why are you doing this? What if your nose gets broken? I can never watch you. Please don't do this. Yeah. And she was like, praying against me.
She's come and watched me like once in the gym.
Mm-hmm.
And I just looked over and she was just like so uncomfortable. She was like,
it's very difficult. Right now, there's not enough women that fight quite yet. Not as many as I would like. And I'm trying to just show women that they're empowering themselves every single day that they train.
Sleeping on the floor.
There's only two empty bunks, though.
She felt like it.
And there's two. I felt like it because you said you couldn't get comfortable.
Because you were supposed to bring in a mattress.
I can sleep on the. I mean, it's the same thing.
But it was on a mattress. You decided to sleep on the floor.
Yeah. A mattress would be on the floor, too.
You offered that from the start.
I offered that because you can't share with people.
I said that when we were sitting outside on the curb.
I don't think Miriam is a team player. She's just a hard girl to get along with, you know, especially in a group setting. And I think that's a big part of this. You know, we're a team and we all have to get together and we all have to work together and make sacrifices, and I don't think she's willing to do that.
Felice, don't you have something else to focus on than picking a fight with me?
Yeah, that's exactly what I want.
When I supposedly started an argument with you.
Don't talk to me.
She always has to have her own way. She's not accommodating. She can't compromise. It's either Miriam's way or the highway.
Leave it alone. She's got a fight this week.
All right. Yeah. I hurt my foot this morning.
I don't know how much weight I'm gonna be able to bear on it. It's gonna make it really difficult for me to fight on Saturday.
Your girl hurting her foot, but she's showing her opponent. She show too much. She tell people too much that where she hurting. Mm-hmm. It's supposed to do that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, make sure she understand that.
Right.
She's showing, she's telling everybody about her foot.
Okay.
Okay, figure that out now.
So, just use the left leg. Mm-hmm. You know, don't be pivoting too hard. Mm-hmm. If people are watching,
mm-hmm.
it's not a show for them. You're not here to entertain them in any way, shape, or form. For whatever reason, if it hurts, box. Go to the bag, box.
I'm hurting, but I'm telling myself at the same time, there's pain in all of this. And if I can't handle my freaking feet hurting from time to time, then I shouldn't be here.
Coming up next.
I just want to focus on my fight.
Pain pushes one fighter to the hospital, and someone in the house has a secret.
Did you tell anybody? Okay, just keep on running up.
Then, fight night.
I need to see how much you can do, okay? Felice.
Yes, sir.
Come forward. Gina. Okay, I want you to come in the ring, and then I want you to focus on you two. I want to see how you do today.
Master Toddy wants to challenge Gina and I because we're going to be fighting each other, and he wants us to compete with each other because that's, you know, that's what's going to push us.
Go!
I want to win. You know, I want to train harder. I want to go to Thailand. I want to fight. You know, I want to train against the best. And this fight is gonna get me there.
Come on, don't stop, come on, go, come on.
When it gets tough, like, I keep going and going and going, and I just don't stop, and no matter how much I wanna quit, I'm not gonna quit.
It's kind of hard to decide who's got the upper hand in that matchup.
Come on, come on.
Felice is totally ripped from head to toe. She's such a strong person.
Come on.
But Gina is a more experienced Muay Thai fighter.
Who gonna stop first? Yeah! All right! Wow! Wow! That's what it's like in the ring. The ultimate goal is to fight in Thailand. It's nowhere else better Muay Thai than in Thailand. We know one thing, sir. The Thai girls are experienced. Mostly the Thai people grow up fighting.
เตรียมตัวก็เตรียมตัวเตรียมร่างกายเตรียมใจด้วยเพราะไปซ้อมให้ดีเช้าวิ่งตื่น6โมงวิ่งเสร็จก็กระโดดเชือกก็เตะกระสอบก็ตียกก็เสร็จก็ล้อเป้า
Did somebody knock?
Yeah. Can I come in?
You. Come on in.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm good.
How's your foot?
It's okay.
Do you want me to rub it out?
Did you tell anybody?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Just keep on
running. Okay. What's wrong with it though?
It's just cramping. Like really hardcore.
Carrie does know about my foot. She knew from the beginning. And I trust her. I don't think she's going to say anything to anybody.
I don't want to go in there and grab okay. ice and stuff. Can you grab me some ice?
Yeah.
And some veggies or something, then just wait. You want to?
I can make a bun right now. I have some green beans. I probably got to eat every 3 hours.
So right here?
Yeah.
It's going to be cold, but...
It's okay. Yeah. I'm so used to it. I already iced it last night.
Yeah. It's good.
I think it was very important to stay quiet about it for her, because if her opponent knew that she was in a lot of pain, I think that her opponent would think that she has an advantage. And I want Gina to win because, you know, I've gotten to know her a lot more than I have Felice.
Thanks for your discretion.
No problem.
Appreciate it.
So how'd you feel when you got picked first?
I was kind of surprised. I was like, why'd they pick me first?
I was just like, I mean, it was good, but it was bad. Like, I wanted to kind of stay on longer. You know, and if I fight and I win, then that'll be great because then I won't have to worry. Like,
my ultimate goal is just to become a better fighter. I don't want to just fight and win. I want to learn as much as I can, win or lose. You know, it's going to be a tough fight, and I want to take every single thing in life that I do as a learning experience.
You know, I'm just going to go in there and fight my fight, and if she beats me, she beats me, but I'm not going to let her beat me.
You nervous?
I'm nervous. I always get nervous to fight, no matter who I'm fighting, you know?
At first, I really thought Felice had the fight until I saw Gina doing pad work. Now I'm kind of banking on Gina.
I only saw Gina work out a little bit, and she didn't look strong at all. I don't think she has, like, that fighter mentality. This color is gonna be in your face all day on Saturday.
Okay, are we tender right here?
Yeah, a little.
Okay, how about on the inside right there?
Mm-hmm, oh, yeah.
On the arch itself, mm-hmm. Is that where the majority of the pain is, mm-hmm. on the arch? It's tough with fighters like yourself. You guys are in a whole different category, basically the psycho category.
Yeah.
I don't know any secretaries or accountants or teachers that kick a heavy bag 400 times a day, so it's hard to relate injuries to the regular person. Probably the best thing to do is to shoot an x-ray. Okay, hold real still for me. Okay, Gina, I'm gonna diagnose this as a grade one sprain. It's actually more than one ligament. I would recommend you stay off of it, but you know, I understand you need to fight. But ultimately, she's gonna have to, probably for this weekend, just suck it up.
Over the last few days, she's just been real quiet, and some girls are saying she's kind of in the zone, but I just think she's feeling a little unsure about herself right now.
I'm a very outgoing person, but once you get me into fight mode, I turn it off. I'm completely different because, you know, I'm here to fight, and I'm not here to make friends.
So I'm getting excited for this weekend. I just hope Felice is strong for it.
I was holding the mitts for her. She hits very hard for a 115-pound woman. She hits very, very hard.
Gina's got good technique, though. That's the thing. Gina, I've watched her, and her Muay Thai skills are good. Just from the beginning, and I feel like she's going to be the one to win.
Felice has way more fights. Like, and ring experience counts for a lot.
If ring experience matters, like, none of us have a chance in Thailand.
If it's going to be an inside fight and, you know, Felice can work her way inside, she'll win. But if Gina keeps Felice away because she has length, like with her front kick and her jab, and can keep Felice at bay, then Gina will win.
I think I'll be happy for either one of them if they win.
Hell yeah, I'll be happy for either one of them.
Really?
It'll be sad to see either one of them go.
I know, you guys, kind of sad.
Coming up next, Felice breaks down.
I just want to focus on my fight.
But is it real?
She was like, already talking about going home.
The head games begin. Then, two girls enter. The loser goes home.
It's a huge day today. I am the first girl to fight, and I am nervous.
First time without my boyfriend. He sent me a good text message today, and he reminded me that, you know, he's always there. I got some nerves in me, definitely, but that's completely normal for me. I'm actually more calm than I ever have been for a fight.
Have you been feeling any tension at all in that house lately? Like, because of the fight tonight?
People are nervous for them, but they're also nervous for who's up next.
Yeah, like, I've been trying to give Felice her space. I've kind of just been
I wouldn't say tiptoeing around her, but I've almost been like bypassing her. Not to be rude or anything, but just to give her the space that I think she's
kind of been bypassing everybody though.
Yeah.
Right now, I think so, definitely.
She's on a really short fuse right now.
Yeah.
I'm just worried about everything. I feel like I have a lot of pressure on me. I was talking to Jennifer yesterday and she said that a lot of the other girls are rooting for Gina. And I found out that I had to pack all my bags and I just felt very overwhelmed.
I just want to focus on my fight and instead I have to be all hectic all day and fumbling around. And I just want to fight and get it over with. I don't have to worry about packing. I don't want to do any of this. I just feel really overwhelmed right now. Just want to focus on my fight.
Remember what I told you before you left? The hardest part with you is the mental and the emotional.
I definitely am daddy's little girl. My dad was also a fighter. And there's 5 kids in my family, and I'm the one that actually ended up being the fighter, which is just odd because, you know, I'm a girly girl.
I don't know, today I just felt really overwhelmed, I think, because there's so much that I have to do before the fight. You know, I gotta pack all my stuff, and I wanna get my hair done, and, you know, and I kinda wanna look cute, because you know how I am, I always like to go in the ring looking cute.
Get your toenails painted good so when you kick somebody in the face, they look good.
I already got a pedicure.
Yeah.
Before a fight, you don't really wanna hear any negative thoughts, nothing. You don't want any negative thoughts being put in your mind, and I knew that if I called my dad, he would make me feel good, and he would make me laugh.
A bulldog, you know that?
Yeah.
Blow through your opponent, you just clean him up.
Yeah.
Non-stop, boom, 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 like a machine gun.
Yeah.
This is what you trained all this time for. Just do it. So all I want you to do is bring me home a belt. All I want. I don't want nothing else.
Yeah.
I don't want nothing from Vegas. I don't need nothing from Thailand. I just want you. I just want a picture of you with your hand raised in victory. That's it. That's all. So, you know, you can do it, girl. I know you can.
All right, let's go.
I mean, Carrie, you heard her in the car, right?
That was just like, she was like already talking about going home.
She was. She goes, well, in case I go home.
Is that what she was
saying?
Yeah,
she's saying you guys want some of my makeup products and stuff.
It was kind of sad, because I was like, well, you know, you shouldn't be thinking like that.
But I didn't know if she was like just doing that to like try to with me, because she's sitting right behind me. Like, who does that? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Do you have any allergies? Do you take any medications at all on a routine basis?
No.
Have you had any injuries to your legs recently at all?
No, not to
okay.
my legs.
Okay, anything else that you know of that's significant? All right, thanks again.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
If she gets you with something good, don't show it on your face. If you're tired, don't show it on your face.
Feliz for one thing is she confident. She can look at me in the eyes. She will do whatever is need to do. She got no fear.
I'm still excited. I'm still confident. I got a lot of positive people around me right now, which is good.
You got the skill, you got the will, you got the want. You're going to Thailand.
Gina also, she have good heart. She want to win, quite strong, quite good technique.
I am a fighter. I've sacrificed a lot, and nobody's gonna take this opportunity away from me.
You look strong. You look strong.
There's no other option for me right now. You know, there's no other option. I have to win. I want this win, and I'm gonna do whatever it takes to make it happen.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Fight Girl! It's an elimination bout. The winner will go to Thailand. The loser will go home.
Coming up next, it's time to fight. Who will win a ticket to Thailand? Felice has the experience, but Gina has the Muay Thai technique.
Fighting out of the blue corner from Buffalo Grove, Illinois, Felice Herrick.
In this fight, I'm gonna kick ass because I came here to fight, I came here to win, I came here to go to Thailand, and nobody's gonna take this opportunity away from me.
And her opponent, fighting out of the red corner, from San Diego, California, Gina Reyes.
I gotta remind myself that no matter what, you know, as hard as it gets, it's not worth it, you know, to back down. I need to push through it for myself.
Okay, let's have a good clean fight. Touch him up, go back to your corner.
I'm kind of nervous for that, my eye, guys.
You can breathe. Keep that right hand in her face. This is your fight. We'll wait around.
Look
right
at me. You've
kick.
Got it. I wouldn't lie to you. Okay? You need to do it. You got 2 minutes. That's it. 2 minutes of your life. What wouldn't you do for 2 minutes?
What's 2 minutes of your life? Nothing, right? Stay strong. Right here.
Going to Thailand. You and I are chilling in Thailand. Okay? Push kick her. Sidestep. Dance.
Okay? Don't keep
running
into that push kick.
Fight! Yeah! Ladies and gentlemen, I have the results of the fight.
I thought Gina had taken the first round. There was no question about that.
I think that Felice did really well. Her technique was good. She overpowered Gina.
And the winner, who will be going to Thailand, ladies and gentlemen, a unanimous decision, fighting out of the blue corner,
are accepted to fight on behalf of the Lionheart Gym. Now you represent your country. Now you are going to Thailand. Congratulations. Felice getting knee from Gina, but her knee is not effective enough to stop Felice's punch. In the third round, Felice know that she is winning, and Felice took over the fight.
I didn't want it to be a close fight. I wanted it to be that there was no doubt in the judge's mind who won that fight. And I kicked ass.
She did good. She came at me with a front kick that I wasn't expecting. It was a lot more solid than I expected she had. She got in there and she did what she needed to do. I'm sorry.
No, there's nothing for you to be sorry about. But I'm proud of you. I really am. She was no joke. She's just intimidating.
Mom?
Yeah?
I won!
You won! Yeah! Good girl!
Unanimous decision, too. I fought like a little bulldog. I was calm and relaxed. I feel that I deserve respect from everybody. I feel that I've earned the respect from everybody. I'm the only one here that knows that they're going to Thailand. Everybody else has to wonder now.
Do you know when you go to Thailand, it's
really
another 20 degree hotter than here.
And I'm not looking forward
we
to that.
We are going to get ready for that.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay. I'm looking forward to
good,
it.
Good, good, good. Good, good. Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
Hey, Gina. Sorry, guys.
No.
It's been a pleasure to be here with the girls and with him for the short time that I've been here.
Next time on Fight Girls.
Master Toddy made us pay for going out.
I'm disciplined.
The ultimate goal to fight in Thailand.
I had to drop 13 pounds.
Those pins are Miriam's face.
I guess you're just the special one in the group.
This is like the Miriam show.